Sliema Malta isn't the best place to go sightseeing. There isn't that much to see. You can just go shopping, you can go dining, you can book a lot of activities and catch the bus from Sliema ferries all over the island, so that's a good place to start. If you want to do sightseeing after all, maybe you have a day to spare and you just want to connect the dots between shopping, maybe start at Fort Sliema. Also a little bit further down is Fort Tigna, and then over there is the Redan Tower. And you can easily catch them by taking the public bus and getting off at the respective stops. Another thing you should see in Sliema are the promenades and the beaches. The beaches aren't sandy beaches though. There are a few along the coastline, but most of them are these rocky shores. There's some rock pools in there and you can go down and admire the ocean and crashing waves. Still, be cautious, especially on such a rough day as today. Don't go near the waves at all because they will wash you out to sea and you shouldn't do that. The eastern tip of St. Julian's Bay is a great place to just soak up the sun in the late afternoon, which is when the sun directly hits you, and it's getting quite warm here actually. Also, if you love snorkeling and diving, just off the coast is the shipwreck of Tug. There's a lot of tours that offer shipwreck diving and all of that. Again, more information on the blog. St. Julian's Bay is also where you will find St. Julian's Tower, a watchtower that was erected in 1658. St. Julian's Tower is one out of 13 towers which the Redan personally financed and gave as a gift to the Knights of Malta. They were meant as a defense mechanism so each one could communicate with the next. They were always within sight of one of the other, so they could easily warn anyone of any intruders. On such a beautiful day, you should easily walk from Spinola Bay in Malta all the way up to Sliema and Fort Tigna, which takes like 90 minutes if you walk briskly. If you want to stop and take photos and just gaze out or have coffee, of course it takes much longer than that, but it's definitely worth it. The Independence Park turns out to be a cat haven. There are cat homes, cat pillows, and a lot of cats. To go shopping is the Point Mall at Fort Tigna. You can see it here. One of the best places to catch a sunset from Sliema Malta is to go towards Fort Tigna, but not quite, because the promenade here offers spectacular views over Fort Manuel and the harbour front. And you can see Valletta in the distance. Pretty cool. You can't actually go into Fort Tigna. It's currently being reconstructed, renovated, being redone. But you've got amazing view all the way to St. Elmo's Lighthouse in Valletta and the bridge in Valletta leading up to St. Elmo's Lighthouse, as well as the view over the harbour and all the way to Fort Manuel. There isn't much you can see of Fort Manuel, even if you get up close, because everything is off limits. And the island itself feels more like an abandoned place. It's a bit eerie. If you like urban exploring, this is a place to go in Sliema Malta. Otherwise, maybe skip it if you like pretty things. Also, the sunset from here isn't that great. Another abandoned site worth checking out on Fort Manuel Island are the Lazarus ruins. They are also kind of off limits, so maybe just watch them from outside. You can find them when you turn right at the security coming from the bay, and just follow the path straight ahead, then you'll find the ruins. Pack hiking shoes because this is the path, so don't come visit on a rainy day because you might slip and fall easily if you don't wear proper shoes. I hope you like my little video about a day trip to Sliema and St. Julian's. If you like to see more, you know, there's a playlist, there's blog articles, like and subscribe and all of that jazz. I hope to see you around for other videos because this entire series on travel in Malta. Stay travel-tastic and bye.